Hi, I'm Peter Sagal. People ask us, what's the secret to Wait, Wait, Don't Tell Me success? And it really is just one thing, one very special element, and its initials are CK. Carl Castle, newsman, comedian, international man of mystery. Over the years, we've been trying to find something he just won't do for a laugh, whether it's his remarkable foreign accents, or should I say, accent, the dignity he's earned over decades and is willing to squander in an instant, or just his willingness to do just about anything we ask of him. I submit these three pieces of evidence for your consideration. First, he shows his lax attitude about controlled substances. Then he demonstrates his remarkably fine ear for speech. And finally, we'll hear one of Carl's signature interpretations of popular song. Kerry, this past week, the U.S. government announced that this country is in the midst of a severe shortage of what?
The U.S. government announced that we have a severe shortage of...
It's something the government would notice.
They would notice. A shortage of... Well, I know the deficit... Right.
Well, maybe Carl has a hint for you. Carl, do you have a hint?
No, Peter, I don't.
Oh, man.
Same from NPR. This is Carl Castle with NPR News. Try it.
I'm Carl Castle, NPR News.
Very good, John. Here is your last quote.
If I become iridescent from it, I become iridescent from it. I'll glow in the dark.
That was a New Yorker.
I'm guessing it's Upper East Side. Yeah.
I'm guessing it's 1686.
Carl actually went back to the Dutch period, yeah. Colonial New York, for that accent.
Peter Stuyvesant!
Exactly. No, anyway, telling the New York Times, that New Yorker did, that she's not going to let news of unsafe levels of mercury stop her from eating what?
Oh, I have no idea.
Thermometers!
Sushi?
Sushi, yes, very good.
Thermometers.
Vanessa, here is your last quote.
Don't stop believing. Hold on to the feeling. Streetlights, people, oh.
Hang on.
Don't stop.
That, of course,
Carl's power ballad.
Yes. Journey's Don't Stop Believin'. That song played and was suddenly cut off and the screen went to black as we said goodbye to what TV show this week?
The Sopranos.
Indeed, The Sopranos. One of our mottos around Wait, Wait is that we are public radio without the dignity. We also lack taste, restraint, and a sense of propriety. Don't believe me? Well, here are some moments where, if we didn't quite cross the line of good taste, we walked right up to it, stuck our toe over it, and felt a cheap thrill. We begin with the first show we ever did in front of a live audience in Salt Lake City, Utah, in January 2000, and a question to panelist Roy Blount Jr. Roy Blount, if a law now under consideration in the Mississippi State Senate passes, men will be arrested and fined for being what? In public.
I remember this exact phrase, in fact. Discernibly turgid.
Yes! Oh. Yes, that's right. The answer is sexually aroused.
No, it's discernibly turgid.
Well, you know.
Oh, is that what that means? No. Boy, am I embarrassed.
The law is intended to restrain lap dancing and the like at strip clubs. It expands the definition of public nudity to include, and I am now quoting from legislative language, the showing of covered male genitals in a discernibly turgid state.
Peter, I occasionally ask this question. Why did we fight the Civil War? What was the whole point?
I do want to point out that the turgid state does not refer to Mississippi. That's... Paula, a travel company in Germany announced this week that they're going to begin catering to airline passengers who would like to travel how?
No!
moon.
Yes, naked. Who among us hasn't struggled to board a crowded airplane and thought, you know what would make this great? Everyone were naked. Well, the Aussie Urlaub Travel Company has heard your pleas. Their first nude charter flight will be this summer.
Nobody's going to want to be on the second one, though, are they?
Nobody wants to be in the flight right after.
Yeah.
It's a day trip to the vacation haven beach island of Usedom in the Baltic Sea. The pilot and flight attendants will be fully dressed. According to the company's founder, though, quote, all the passengers will fly naked, but they are only allowed to undress once they are in the plane. But then they will be able to enjoy the hour-long flight in the way God intended, unquote.
Now, let me get this. And how exactly do they undress on the plane?
There's
this much room. How many elbows in the face are you going to take while somebody's disrobing?
I think zippers. Neck to ankle zippers is the only way it can work.
Velcro.
Yeah,
possibly Velcro. Yeah, or just like a really... just a not well-stitched clothing. That's another...
Yeah,
you know, you have that one string and you start pulling.
You ready to play?
I'm ready.
All right, here is your first quote.
Do you recall any bleeding through your pants in 2001?
Now, Andrew, I want you to think before you answer, because... No, that was an actual question asked by Congressman Tom Davis at a hearing on Wednesday, who was asked about some unsightly stains on his pants while under oath.
That would be Roger Clemens.
Yes, Roger Clemens, the greatest pitcher who ever lived, registered trademark, took to Capitol Hill this week to defend what is left of his good name. Sitting right next to him was Brian McNamee, who told the House panel that he had injected Mr. Clemens with steroids, human growth hormone, through the rear, of course, leading to that alleged outbreak of unsightly bleeding. Still, Clemens denied everything, but he may have given himself away. At the end, he said he was tired from 4 hours of testimony, hard questioning. He said he needed to pick me up, and before he could stop himself, he reflexively turned his back on McNamee and dropped his trousers.
Didn't they talk a lot about the MRI? Did I misunderstand this, that the MRI was, they were his derriere?
Had to get, because he had a strange mass on his derriere.
Right, right.
This was discussed in the halls of Congress, the mass on Roger Clemens' derriere.
Look, it's more intelligent and less expensive than what they usually spend their time.
Yeah, I know.
So, count yourself lucky.
On the way out of the hearing room, of course, a small boy, tears in his eyes, came up to Clemens and said, "Say it ain't so, Roger." And Clemens, eyes downcast, threw a bat at him. Adam, after parents complained, Woolworth stores in Britain have stopped selling a line of young girls' beds that had what brand name?
Lolita.
Exactly right.
That word just trips off the tongue.
It really does.
Yeah.
Lolita, light of my life, fire of my loins, my sin, my soul, my day bed.
Yeah.
The Lolita mid-sleeper combi is aimed at 6-year-old girls. It's a whitewashed wooden bed with pull-out desk and cupboard. Staff at Woolworth say they'd never heard of Nabokov's novel about a young girl's extremely inappropriate relationship with her stepfather. They said, quote, "We had to look it up on Wikipedia, but we certainly know who she is now," end quote. After further Wikipedia research, the company has decided to pull other products from their shelves, including the Hannibal Lecter Easy Bake Oven.
Sure.
The Scarlet Letters refrigerator magnet set, and the Catherine the Great My Little Pony play set. Charlie, the Florida Senate considered legislation this week that would fine any driver who takes to the roadway with what automotive accessory?
These subverbal human noises I'm making, Peter, are an appeal for a hint.
I understand. Well, if the law passes, it essentially you'll have to neuter your Ford Explorer.
Lengthy tailpipes?
No. I'm being far more literal.
Good one.
As one account put it, it makes the truck look like the south end of a northbound cow or bull.
Udders?
No, not udders. I stress bull.
Oh, testicles.
Yes.
fake testicles. This is what I say to people who are offended by this. Do not blame us for talking about it. Blame the Florida legislator for taking it up as an issue. These are ersatz scrotums. They are known by their brand name Truck Nuts, N-U-T-Z, and they are increasingly popular among drivers of pickups, SUVs, and other manly vehicles, which apparently are not already compensation enough. A new state law in Florida may make them illegal. Senator Kerry Baker proposed the bill, but Senator Stephen Geller disagrees with the proposition. Says
they debated this?
They debated this. That's my point. Don't blame us. Senator Geller...
Did someone move the table to notion?
Exactly. Senator Geller disagreed with the proposition. He said, quote, I find it shocking we tell people with metallic testicles on their bumpers that this is a violation, unquote. And this is the best part. Another state senator, Jim King, actually admitted to owning a pair, which he called, quote, an expression of truckliness.
See, I have a perfect solution for all this.
What is your perfect solution?
Truck underwear.
There you are.
Hey, when you said it was they were ersatz testicles, I thought ersatz was a little animal.
No, no. They harvest them.
I was like, ersatz. What kind of animal is an ersatz?
I thought, is the bill passed or not?
The bill is, I believe, under debate.
We must save the ersatz. It
passed the Florida Senate, and it will go to the House. And if the House passes it and the governor signs it, you will no longer be able to drive your trucks around with the truck nuts on them.
It was
very unsuccessful, Peter. They tried them first in North Dakota, but in the middle of February, they all went back in the trunk.
Not My Job is the game where we invite celebrity guests onto the show, and we thank them for their time by making them answer a few really silly questions. The one we're about to hear is from June of 2007, when filmmaker and provocateur Michael Moore joined us on stage at the Chase Auditorium in downtown Chicago.
Our guest today decided to make his first documentary almost 20 years ago because he had been fired from his last job. That was either, depending on your point of view, a very good thing or a national tragedy. He has since won an Oscar for his documentary Bowling for Columbine. His Fahrenheit 9/11 became the highest grossing and perhaps most controversial documentary ever made. His film Sicko opens nationwide next week. Michael Moore, welcome to Wait, Wait, Don't Tell Me.
Thank you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.